Welcome to One Chemistry. Always try to do your best. Now we are going to see Binaphthyl compound and its chirality. Later we will see how we can find R and S configuration. Stay tuned. What is inside this video? First, we are going to see how Binaphthyl is chiral by chiral axis, then examples of it. Then we are going to see the prediction of R and S configuration, and I given the some representative example, Binol, Binam, Binap and NOBIN. Before getting to that, we should know chirality. Chirality means the structure and shapes differ in the 3D space. You can understand it by shoe. You might wonder why left shoe don't fit for right leg, right leg don't fit for left shoe. So definitely left shoe not equal to right shoe. So the shoes are definitely not same, left shoe definitely not equal to right shoe. Because shoes are chiral, they differ in the 3D space. The 3D space is called stereo. Technically it's a stereochemistry. Normally these shoes have mirror image relationship, they call enantiomers. So you should know chirality. The chemical compounds also can be chiral. It is classified into 4 types: 0 dimension, 1 dimension and 2 dimension and 3 dimension. 0 dimension means chiral center, the 4 different attached atoms in the carbon which create the chirality. Chiral axis, which is our today's interest. The single dimensional axis create the chirality mostly by phenyl aline compound, and two dimensional chirality, the plane creates chirality. The known compounds are ansa compounds and cyclopentane compound. Three dimensional chirality created by spiraling. It is also called spiral chirality. But today's our interest is one dimensional chirality, particularly with binaphthyl compound. We are going to see how it is chiral and how we can find R and S configuration. Let us understand the binaphthyl. Binaphthyl is the compound, two binaphthyl system attached with a single bond, and you have substitution in the OH there. How really look is, it's the perpendicular plane or some kind of tilted plane. You can draw in 3D with two above the plane molecule. It will be like screw, above the plane comes again and again. So you have to know the molecule, how it really look and how you can draw in 3D. How the binaphthyl is chiral? The chiral axis create the chirality in binaphthyl system and makes it optically active. Let us look at the binaphthyl system. If you remove the ring, we get clean tetrahedral kind of arrangement. It will be definitely optically active. It is like carbon attached with 4 different groups. But really they are twisted system. So the chirality created by chiral axis rather than chiral center. So you have to imagine like chiral center. So in the binaphthyl, two perpendicular planes create the axial chirality. The concept here is, without chiral carbon, chirality is possible. Binaphthyl is chiral due to its chiral axis. Before we get into R and S configuration, you should know the molecule is chiral or not. If the attachments are smaller one, the most of the time we won't say R and S because of the rapid rotation of the single bond. This system represented as less chiral because it will resimize. The hydrogen is smaller and is less chiral, mostly we won't mention R and S. Then even with one substituent the rotation is possible, we won't say. Only both groups are bulky mean we can say R and S. So bulkiness decides the chirality, it prevents the pre-rotation, it creates the chiral nature. Let us see the important thing, viewing side. It is a deciding factor for R and S, you should master it. Viewing side is the thing from the which side you are seeing the molecule. Here I given the binaphthyl, you are seeing the molecule. Your top of it is CA, bottom is OH, right hand side is COH and left hand side is D there. How we can draw in 3 dimensional to 2 dimensional? You have to draw from thick line and thin line. Thick line represents you are near to the molecule, thin line represents you are away from it. So above is CH group, which is A, below is OH, which is B, right side is COH, and left side is D, which is CH. So you have to master the viewing angle. It is the deciding factor. Let us see how we can find R&S. You have to imagine the molecule in 3D and you have to choose the viewing side first. In that viewing side, front side gets higher priority than back side. Then you have to go with CIP rules. The CIP rules go with atomic number. Then you have to find the orientation. The clockwise mean it is R, new name is P. Anti-clockwise mean S, new name is M. P and M stand for plus and minus. Here the important fact is the changing viewing side won't change the results. Let us look at the molecule and analyze our fact. Here you are seeing near the molecule. A is above you because the solid line. B is below you. Then C is right hand side of you. D is left hand side of you. So let us bring the same fact here. The thicker line above and below. A is CH, B is OH, right side is C, left side is D, OH and CH. So if you draw the configuration 1, 2, 3, 4 mean, you have clockwise, it is R, the new name is P. Here the important fact you should know is the front side hydrogen even get higher priority than backside OH. So don't directly apply CIP rule, first you go with the viewing side higher priority. Then we should confirm the fact the changing viewing side won't change the results. Here you are looking at the molecule. The left side one, the bottom is OH of you and A is above you. C is right hand side of you, D is left hand side of you. If you draw the configuration, it is clockwise. The same molecule you are seeing from top side. Here the above one is OH, below is CH, then left hand side of you is OH, right hand side of you is CH. So if you draw, you have again same clockwise direction. So you have don't change in configuration. So the fact is changing the viewing angle won't change the results. Then like any other chiral carbon, the mirror image always have opposite configuration. They are enantiomers. Here given the same molecule with mirror image relationship. Here the left hand side molecule we are seeing between OH and CH, which is the front side, and 3 and 4 is right and left side. So if you draw it, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Clockwise direction, it is R there. So if you draw it, it gets clockwise direction, it is R there. So the right side molecule, the mirror image relationship. The top of E is CH, bottom is OH. The right side of E is CH, left side is OH there. So if you arrange the configuration, it will be anti-clockwise. It is S orientation. So mirror image always have opposite configurations. Then let us see the trick to find R&S. Normally if the compound is given, you have to draw from above the plane to above the plane. In the given compound, you have to draw the curve from above the plane to above the plane. Here a given 1 to 2. You can start from either 2 or 1, the answer will be same. So if you draw from 1 to 2, you find the shape of the curve. If the shape of the curve is reverse S shape, it is R configuration. If it is S shape, it is S configuration. The left side shape I given, it's the reverse S, that's why it is R. The right side one, it is S, that's why it is S configuration. Shape of the curve decide the configuration. Then I given some example to practice yourself. The first one is acid, second one is a heteroatom containing binaphthyl, then the binap, then the side substituted binaphthyl. So you have to go with same viewing angle, same 1 and 2 on front side, it is in vertical direction. So you have to find it. So if you find it, first one gets R, second one gets S, third one is R, fourth one is S. So you have to master by practicing the examples. Let us summarize what we've seen. The binaphthyl compounds are chiral due to the chiral axis. Before getting to R&S configuration, you have to find the chirality of the compound. The bulkiness decides the chirality. More the bulkier, better will be the chirality. Then if you find orientation, clockwise mean R, new name is P. Anti-clockwise mean S, new name is M. Then you have to master the viewing angle to get R&S configuration. So you have to imagine the molecule in 3D in better way. Then the new tricky method, if you have S configuration, it is S. If you have reverse S configuration, it is R. So you have to master R and S by simple trick. Then the chiral axis also can be possible by side chain attachments. The important fact you should know is, changing the viewing angle of the compound won't change the results. That's all from this video. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below. If you really like my video, subscribe and share.